Hey everyone, welcome to the Quad Spot, your spot for the next generation of YouTube. I'm Randy.
I'm Dave.
I'm Jay.
And Steve couldn't be with us today, so we have, as usual, recruited the help of one Mr. Jason Ergo.
How's it going, guys?
And our guest today is Greg and Jeff, no relation, the Cameron brothers.
Hey, guys. Nice to meet you guys.
Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks for coming, guys.
Absolutely. Glad to be here.
Now, we met for the first time over at the Toronto YouTube gathering.
Yeah, yes, we did.
So for the people that watch the Quad Spot that have never watched the Cameron Brothers YouTube channel, what can they expect when they go over?
Funny skits. Anything that we find just inside our brain. I don't know how to explain it. Like, we love doing funny skits. We want to do some serious stuff, too, just... all around, mostly in the funny skits sort of area category right now. Yeah.
So whatever your brains can conjure out is what you guys are doing, right?
Yeah.
That's funny.
We have a weird sense of humor, but I think in a way it touches on society, you know? We had a video of the awkward handshake, and it had a little bit of fame on YouTube for a tiny bit, and yeah, we want to keep it up.
Yeah, we're all about awkward moments in life. That's what, you know, makes us laugh, just awkward moments that everybody share.
So, like, awkward silences?
Awkward silences, yeah.
Awkward everything you experience in life. We really want to play on that. Because I think with our generation, that's really what people relate with in a weird way. People relate with awkward moments, I think.
Like that one?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. It was awkward, yeah.
The awkward interview.
Yeah, awkward interview, there you go.
Now, you guys get the same kind of questions that we get about the equipment that you guys use. So what kind of equipment do you guys use?
Okay, so we use, like a lot of people do, the Canon DSLR.
Ergo knows of Canon DSLRs now.
Yeah.
This is like, what do we got here?
Yeah, man. It's all about the lens and that shallow depth of field.
Which one is that, though, there? That's
the Canon 70.
I got the T2i, to be honest. It's the same thing, really, but cheaper.
A little bit cheaper.
But we're all about the 50 lens so far.
All we have is a 50 lens so far.
Yeah, I have those. They're great.
The Nifty 50s are good.
50, I find it's like the most all-around usable lens.
It gives you that shallow depth of field, right? Mm. Which is a very filmic look, you know, when your subject is in focus and you've got the soft background. And yeah, it just reads kind of pro. So if we make more money, yeah, we'll go for better, wider lenses. But, you know, the camera's around $2,000, but lenses can get ridiculous.
Small lenses, like, so.
But they last for life, though. That's the best part. So you can just swap them out, you know?
Exactly, man. Exactly. Yeah.
Well, they last for life until you drop them on the floor.
Yeah. It happens once.
So the only problem, though, with this kind of camera is when you hold it by hand, you're going to get a lot of shake, right?
Yeah.
Right.
So what we use is the good old GlideCam. We have the 1000. I would actually suggest the 2000,
but this is okay. Yeah,
yeah, the 1000. You still get that swaying, but we kind of work with it. If you guys have watched like The Office, right?
Yeah,
it has that kind of handheld, you know, agitation to it, so it works very nicely. Yeah, portable too, and yeah, it's hard to get used to. You got to.
Yeah, it's all kind of in the skill. Like, you don't just hold it, but you just kind of.
Yeah, yeah. It's a skill within itself to learn how to use one of those things. I mean, I spent about 2 weeks learning how to use one and finally got it down. In fact, our school has one that we could take down at any time, and the vest and everything, which is pretty awesome.
Yeah, that's amazing. It's a great opportunity.
Now, for people who aren't very techie, and don't know what a glide cam does, like myself, what does a glide cam do?
It basically, it smooths out everything.
So it's sort of like a Steadicam, but not.
It's weight balance. There's weights on both sides here, and you equal out the weights. It's, you have to kind of equal it out.
So it's a counterbalance, right?
Yeah, counterbalance. Yeah.
It counterbalances the camera.
So if you've seen like any of those shots in movies where people go up the stairs, like an army scene where they're raiding the house and they have to go up the stairs to get inside. You can run upstairs with these, especially with the vest, and it just looks like you're floating up the stairs. But it's a huge operation. I mean, you need wireless. If you don't have a proper camera, you need wireless controls for like focus and zoom. And they'll have these outriggers that are just outstanding looking in the end for bigger operations.
But even, man, with the GlideCam 2000, I've seen footage of somebody running down his street, and it looks like it's on a dolly. It's amazing.
There is a lot of skill involved, though, as we learned. We thought once we got it, we'd just run anywhere and it'd be smooth, but there's a lot of skill involved in operating it. So,
now, how does something like that compare to a camera that has image stabilization in it?
To be honest, I never find that much of a difference with image stabilization.
Image stabilization on a good lens, it could really do well, but I think the glide cams and all the steady cams, different companies, same thing in the end, though. The glide cam hardware does a lot better job.
The camera that did take a fall right before the Toronto gathering that we were at actually does have image stabilization in it. And I can walk around with that thing just holding a camcorder. It's a Sony HDR CX550V camera. And that thing, you walk and it doesn't look like you're walking at all. It does do the
really thing. That's cool.
Yeah, I have a Nikon S6100, which I took to San Diego about a month and a half ago, and I was able to just track like birds or whatnot across the sky. It was like I was on a fluid tripod head. It was amazing.
Really?
Start zooming in, you'll notice problems a little bit, but it's actually really good. So I'm just wondering how it compares to hardware like that.
Well, I guess this is doing it raw. It's doing with the raw footage, right?
Yeah.
Or you're stabilizing it from the footage being shot instead of doing it post.
Yeah.
Some of these, like Ergo's camera had optical image stabilization on the camera itself, and it works,
To be honest, I've never seen it well done yet. I wonder if we have it too, eh?
Even this says, and it doesn't work nearly as well as my Sony did. I don't know if you can read that there.
Stabilizer on off, yeah.
That's on the lens, right?
Well, yeah, it doesn't work as well on this lens, I'd say, as it did on my Sony, though.
We don't have it on the 50, but yeah, I wasn't even aware of that, actually. You know, it comes down to the guy with the camera. You know, everyone depends on the technology or the... There's always going to be a newer, better camera, but it comes down to you, the angles you used, and like your body movements. When I film, I literally like squat and I lock my arms in a certain position. So it comes down to you and how you use your camera. It's a skill. It's an art. It's totally an art.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I guess it's all the shot that you're looking for.
Yeah, I definitely recommend this. I feel like movement to any kind of scene you're filming, just it adds production value to it. So yeah, I'd highly recommend
the GlideCam. We have the GlideCam 1000.
Yeah.
Maybe the GlideCam 2000 is better for DSLRs. We're not sure.
Where do you guys go to get your inspiration? What do you look into for your videos? Because you guys are hilarious. There's got to be something what you look into to get the inspiration.
We base it off life.
It's everyday life. The moments, I think we both experience a lot of awkward moments in everyday life. I mean, that's the inspiration for everything. It's life. It's your interactions. Yeah. And the inspiration, you can tell the story about handshake awareness.
Oh, yeah. Like, we've been in this house, actually, for only like a couple months. We just moved to downtown Toronto, and Awkward Handshake is based off a dude I met from downstairs. If you've watched Awkward Handshake, he went for the fist pump, I went for the handshake, and it was really awkward, and I thought I'm never going to be friends with this guy again. Of course, we're like really good friends now, so that's kind of funny.
It's kind of a universal thing, the awkward handshake, and I think that's why it kind of took off. Because nowadays, you know, there's so many different handshakes. I mean, the fist pump, the slide fist pump, there's so many things going on. And I think everybody experiences that problem, including myself and many people. So I think that's why that video has some...
The best ideas come out from life. Like, look at Steven Spielberg and E.T., right? Like, it's about an alien, but it's actually about the fact that Spielberg was adopted. Oh, no, he wasn't adopted, sorry. That Spielberg's parents broke up. So E.T. is all about really himself. So if you have ideas, you know, they're usually the best when you're kind of drawing from yourself and your actual experiences. Trying to make up something from, you know, scratch, I believe.
I thought you were going to say you actually got abducted by an alien or something.
Yeah. Adopted, yeah. Yeah, man.
So what do you see coming next? Like, do you have any projects in mind that you're going to be working on, or are you still deciding which script you're going to go with?
Right now, we're trying to kind of get a feel for what we're aiming for, because most YouTube channels kind of have a thing. But right now, we're just kind of exploring. We did a skit yesterday on Game of Thrones, which is a popular TV series. So right now, we're trying to find what works for us. I think we're going to play on the whole awkward encounters thing, because that obviously sold on YouTube. So,
for instance, like, you know that moment, we had an idea where, like, you want to get to an elevator and there's someone in it, but the person doesn't open it for you. He just looks at you and it just, like, closes. So something like that. We just want to plan on ideas.
Yeah.
But really...
And what about when you meet somebody? And they're like, oh, yeah.
I'll be myself. I thought that Endless Grind, I mixed it up with Eddie Grind, so I called you Eddie for some reason. Gather.
But that could work. That was an awkward thing.
Funny, right? Yeah, it was I corrected Jeff. I'm like, no, he's Randy Morton. Yeah. But to be honest, man, I looked at your name tag.
I thought you had a good memory, but I guess that was just okay.
Yeah. Makes me feel a bit better. We've been on the spot there.
Well, you guys have been brothers for, you know, all your life.
Yes.
So how is it being brothers on YouTube and working together on this stuff?
Well, the great thing about being brothers is there's no barrier. You know, we've been through everything together. You know, we've been in a million fights. We're very honest with each other. So when it comes to shooting, there's no barrier. We tell each other if what we're doing sucks, you know, like if I'm doing something that's not working, then he'll tell me. There's no barrier, which makes for a very healthy film environment, I think, you know.
Yeah.
You know, done.
There's something about directing people, like, from a director's perspective, it is kind of nerve-wracking, because you'll tell somebody, like, yeah, that was good, but in your head, you're just like, I'm not going to use that at all, right?
Right.
So I'll just tell Jeff, like, do it again, and then we get it right. So
yeah, our film method is we do a lot of takes. We do as many takes as it takes to get that shot, you know? And if you're behind the camera, you'll know if you got that shot, and that's it, you know?
Yeah, you couldn't do that back in the day, especially when you had film running through a camera and a whole crew, and you had to pay all that money. But now with digital, you pop out a SIM card, you delete that thing.
Yeah, time isn't really money for us, you know.
Yeah.
We just go around with our camera and we have all the footage we want. So, you know, we take our time, which is a luxury for sure.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's kind of the spin we want to put on our channel, because I want to be a filmmaker, right? From my background is filmmaking. His background is acting. So YouTube to us, you know, it's not just about getting views and subscribers. To be honest, it's just like... exercise for us in our profession. So yeah, one kind of spin we want to put on our channel is to give it some production value, right? Instead of just doing kind of a one take thing with our cell phone. So yeah, kind of our take on it.
Now, when you guys get in these arguments over the creativeness of the shot, does one of you guys end up with, I'm gonna go tell mom?
You know what's funny, actually? Our mom is a very talented writer, so we do go tell mom. Like, she's we're in film. She's a playwright. And so we grew up in a very crazy, creative household.
Yeah.
And it's a little weird. Most people, like, if you're going to acting or something, most parents look down on that. Like, they're, like, warning their children, like, don't do that. You know, it's very sketchy. But, like, in my household, it was supported almost too much. So I've always been a little bit worried that, you know, like, maybe I shouldn't do this. I'm getting too much support from my parents to do this. So it's kind of a weird alternate reality from what most people experience, you know.
And what about in your household, Greg? Was it the same?
Very similar.
My version. Yeah.
Very similar.
My parents hate me.
No, but in the end, you know, if Jeff and I have an argument, like, no, I think it should be that way, I think it should be that way, then we shoot it. We shoot different versions, right? And it all comes together in the edit. We shoot a lot. We shoot a lot of takes, and then we pick and choose. And then it ends up being like a 30-second thing. You have no idea how much we film.
All right. So, well, we already know all this is still the better looking in this room.
Yes.
Which one of you two is the better looking?
It's a big argument between us. It's...
I'd say Jeff is.
Yeah, I gotta stand too long.
No, fine.
He's lying. You
it's
know,
our combined look. Like,
we pretty much look the same, so it's hard to argue.
So we're both on screen, you know.
Yeah, that's we get the whole twin thing all the time. And the funny thing is, there's another Cameron brother who isn't here, and he doesn't look anything like us, actually.
Yeah, was he at the gathering?
That's okay.
No, he wasn't.
You saw Handshake Awareness, right? He's the guy I
he's
have
the third
handshake
guy.
With. He looks a lot. He's a little bit shorter. He looks a lot different from me.
And just to clarify that, there, you said you get the twin thing all the time. Are you actually twins, or you're not twins?
No, we're not actually twins.
At all, yeah.
That's why it can be annoying at times.
Yeah. We get, you know, yeah. Are you guys twins? Are you guys brothers?
Yeah, all the time.
Face palm, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh. Well,
yep.
Now, so you said you have a third brother.
Yes.
When are you guys going to tell him he's adopted?
We tell him every day.
Okay. I want to make sure that, you know, we could use the – I was hoping we'd use the show to break the news that he was adopted.
But, well, find out now, I guess. You know, we try.
Now, is he part of the troop or –
Yes, he's been in school. That's why we haven't been with him a lot recently. But he's going to move to Toronto too, and you'll see a lot more of him.
Yeah, he'll be coming up soon. Yeah.
So then it'll be the Cameron brothers and the adopted Cameron brother.
Yes. Mailman's son.
Milkman.
Mailman.
Randy, do you have your closing script ready?
You know I don't. But unfortunately, that is all the time that we do have with you guys. It was great to, you know, get to pick your brain on what kind of stuff you guys do, both on your channel and in your personal lives. I'm glad that you guys argue like brothers, because it's you guys and not me. If you'd like to check out the Cameron brothers, their information will be in the description. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and circle us on Google+. And you can also do the same with the Cameron brothers. I wanted to thank both the Cameron brothers and Jason Ergo for being on the show with us today. And check out our website, thequadspot.com. And if you think that you're good enough to be on the Quad Spot, because you probably are, you can send us an email through the website.
Hey, when are we going to tell Steve he's adopted?
That'll be next week's show, Jay. Thanks for watching, everyone.